This video is an example of the addition rule for probability. A card is drawn from a standard deck of 52 playing cards. What is the probability that the card will be a spade or a seven? Now I'm going to use the addition rule for probability. One clue is the word or here. So when you see the word or it's implied in the problem, it's typically going to be the addition rule for probability. So the formula for the addition rule for probability is the probability of event A or B is the probability of event A plus the probability of event B. And if they are not mutually exclusive, then we have to subtract out the probability of A and B occurring together. So looking back at the problem, we need to determine whether or not getting a spade and getting a seven can occur at the same time. Well, yes, they can. We can get a seven of spades when we draw a card from a standard deck of 52. So this is a situation where our two events are not mutually exclusive and we're going to have to subtract out their intersection. So plugging into this formula where my event A will be getting a spade, there are 13 spades in a deck of 52 cards, so that's going to be 13 out of 52, plus the probability we'll let event B be getting a 7. There are 4 sevens in a deck of cards, one for each suit, so there's 4 out of 52. Now, because we can get a 7 of spades, we've double counted here, so we need to subtract out where we've double counted. So there is 1 7 of spades out of a deck of 52, and I need to subtract that out. Again, it got double counted here, and leaving it all as one fraction, that's going to be 16 out of 52. A fraction in its most reduced form is going to be 4 out of 13. Or if you want to, you can convert that to decimal. Okay, and then rounding to 4 decimal places. Okay, I get 0.3077. So double checking my answer here, this is a valid probability. Remember, all probability needs to fall between 0 and 1 inclusive. Sometimes you run across an OR problem for probability, where if you don't subtract out the intersection, you get a probability greater than 1 here. And that should be a clue that there's something wrong. Okay, you may need to go back and determine whether or not you forgot to subtract out that intersection. Now, to extend this problem briefly, let's say I wanted to find the probability of getting a spade or a heart. Okay, so here I have a situation where the two events, spade and heart, are mutually exclusive because it is not possible to get a card that is both a spade or a heart. So in this situation, I don't need to subtract out the probability of them occurring together. It's just going to be the probability of getting a spade plus the probability of getting a heart. Okay, so that's going to be 13 out of 52 because there's 13 spades, and also same number of hearts, 13 out of 52. This is pretty much half the deck, okay, because there's 4 suits. And that's going to be 26 out of 52. Okay, or 0.5.